We're taking a look now at James chapter 1, verses 9, 10, and 11, where we read this. Let the lowly brother glory in his exaltation, but the rich in his humiliation, because as a flower of the field he will pass away, for no sooner has the sun risen with a burning heat than it withers the grass. Its flower falls, and its beautiful appearance perishes. So the rich man also will fade away in his pursuits. Now, James began his letter by talking about difficult times in the life of a Christian. He called them trials or tests. Then he spoke about the need to ask God for wisdom, yet to ask in faith. Next, James added another thought. He said this in verse 9, let the lowly brother glory in his exaltation, but the rich in his humiliation. As much as it is appropriate for the lowly to rejoice when God lifts them up, so it is appropriate, but it's far more difficult, for the high, the rich, to rejoice when they are brought to humiliation by testings and trials. In this, the poor brother can forget his earthly poverty, and the rich brother can forget his earthly riches. They can put more of a focus on heavenly things and find themselves equal in Jesus Christ. Though we can understand the relative poverty and riches as trials or tests of a living faith that a Christian may deal with, it nonetheless seems that James has made a sudden shift in his subject. He's shifted from trials and wisdom to riches and humility. In some ways, the book of James is like the book of Proverbs or other Old Testament wisdom literature, where it can jump from topic to topic and back again to a previous topic. So James adds this warning to the rich brother, because as a flower of the field, he will pass away. Trials serve to remind the rich and the high that though they are comfortable in this life, it is still only this life, which fades as the grass grows brown and the flowers fade away. In the land of Israel, there's a variety of beautiful flowers that spring to life just when the rains come in the spring, but they only last for a short time before they wither away. And on the scale of eternity, this is how quickly the rich man also will fade away in his pursuits. Now, the riches of this world will certainly fade away, but James says more than that. He tells us something about the rich man himself. He says that not only his riches, but the rich man also will fade away. If we put our life and our identity into things that fade away, we will fade away also. How much better to put our life and our identity into things that will never fade. If a man is only rich in this world, then when he dies, he leaves his riches. But if a man is rich before God, when he dies, he goes to his riches. Brothers and sisters, I don't know if relatively speaking you are rich or poor, but make sure this. Make sure your real riches are in the world beyond, and ask God to set that right in you today.